So we were discussing about e-banking, okay? And we were on the disadvantages of e-banking, right? Advantages we have discussed yesterday. Now we were on the topic disadvantages of e-banking. The main disadvantage of every online work, the technical issues, okay? Due to the network failure or technical issues, you may not be able to access your transactions successfully, right? Then risk of fake banking websites. Any bank, any fraudulent organization, any fraud company can create a website which looks like authentic website, which looks like a true website, but actually it is not legal. So you may get prone to risk on creating account in such websites. Okay. Difficult to adopt by illiterate people. The persons who are not familiar with the internet terms, who are not having internet knowledge, like in rural areas, still there are many people who are unaware about the technology. So they cannot avail this facility. Security issues. Your password may be hacked. Okay. Lack of direct contact between bank and customer. There are so many things which you need to discuss face to face by personally or physically visiting the bank. But online, when you are dealing, accessing your transactions, there is less face to face contact with the bank owner. Okay, so that can also act as a drawback or demerit of your e-banking. I'm speaking some terms. These terms are interchangeable. I'm speaking some of the terms, and these terms are interchangeable. So don't get confused what question has come. Merits, benefits, advantages. Okay? Demerits, disadvantages, drawbacks, or limitations. Limitations, drawback, demerits, and disadvantages. All these terms are interchangeable. Clear? So that was about your e-banking concept. Now, next concept is block. Already I have discussed with you in the offline classes. So I proceed with the next part of internet. That is your part seven. This is part seven. Okay. Now, our next con is the MS Word file visible? All right. Our next concept is e-shopping. Now, e-shopping, already you people are doing it. There is nothing new in this. You people are already doing this job. You are doing this process. Like you book some product from Amazon, Flipkart, Myantra.com. Okay. So as per your favorite website or as per your likeness for the product, you place an order with the concerned website. Okay. You fulfill all the formalities and the same product is delivered to you at your doorstep. Actually, e-shopping means online shopping. Okay, electronic shopping. Sale and purchase of goods done by sitting at one place. Maybe your home. You are not physically visiting the shops. You are not physically visiting the showrooms. Sitting at your home, using the internet facility, you are booking an order for a product. You are making payment for the product online via your debit or credit card, or maybe you set the option for cash on delivery. That is up to you, depending upon your convenience. And the same product you receive within a gap of few days. Right? Clear? Wide variety of products is available. Wide range is available. Suppose you want to purchase one jacket. So many brands will be available. So many colors will be available. It is up to you which brand you want to purchase. You want to purchase iPods or you want to purchase a mobile. Then also different type of brands will be available. It will be up to you which brand suits you. Depending upon the cost, depending upon the color, depending upon the taste, right? So these are the common e-shopping websites: Flipkart.com, Snapdeal.com, Amazon.in, Jabong.com, Myntra, Pepperfry. Okay? And I think many of you are using Amazon.in. Now, what are the advantages of e-shopping? Okay, if I don't go with the what is typed here, what are your views about the advantages of e-shopping? Don't read what is shown on the screen. You are doing shopping from Amazon. Might you have purchased many products for your home? What are your views? What benefits you receive from online shopping? Anyone would like to discuss? Anyone, child? Yes, Arshin, what are your views? Unmute yourself.
Good afternoon, sir.
Very good afternoon.
Sir, there are various advantages of e-shopping. Like, sir, the most convenient is that it saves the time and our efforts. And most importantly, we get good discounts. We get the products at lower prices. And moreover, we have got the convenience of shopping at home only. And most importantly, we get the detailed information about the products.
Okay, fine. Not bad. Good. Convenient, easy, easily manageable, no wastage of time, fast process, wide variety of products is available, wide range is available. Okay, we have so many choices available with us. We get discounts, we get schemes, some packages, some combo packs. Like if you are purchasing a mobile of Oppo mobile of rupees 20,000, you may receive headphones as a complimentary gift. Or if you are purchasing iPods of Apple company, you may receive some gift as a compliment. So such schemes are always available depending upon the website you are visiting. Clear? Then what are the demerits? Demerit is you may not receive the delivery of the product. Most important drawback is the risk of debit and credit card information. Fraudulent payments can be done. Payment received from you, goods were not delivered to you. Or if goods were delivered, they were not of right quality. They were not the same product which you have booked. Some low quality product, some wrong product has been delivered to you. Okay? Right? Then lack of interactivity. Suppose you are physically moving to a shopping mall. Aap sweater purchase karne gaye ho apne liye. Agar aap physically shop pe jate ho, you can wear the sweater in the dressing room. You can test, you can check the size, you can check the color, you can check the material by touching the material. Or agar size comfortable nahi hai, you can change the size. But this is not so convenient in online shopping. You place the order, product comes to you. Later on, you get to know the size is not comfortable. Then to change the order is a long process. It's also a hectic job. Okay, so that is lack of interactivity. Next is e-reservation. Again, you plan for a movie at PVR Mall or Curo, and you already book the tickets via online facility. Using online reservation system, you want to go to New Delhi. You book your railway tickets online or bus ticket online or airway tickets online. That is called e-reservation. Booking tickets or hotel rooms online. Your family plans for a visit to hill station in June and July, suppose. So you people book the hotel online only. You make the desired payment and you book the room. Might the hotel has given some packages to you people because the season is on. So packages are available and depending upon your likeness, you can place the order. That is called e-reservation or online reservation of tickets, maybe railway, airway tickets, movie tickets or hotel rooms. Okay. Now, what are the application areas where you can use the e-reservation? Travel tickets. I just told you airway or railway, hotel rooms, sport matches, movies and theaters, and any event. Any event is going to occur in your city. Okay. Suppose a renowned celebrity is going to visit the city and he is going to deliver a seminar or in some auditorium or in some hotel in a big hall. So you can book tickets online for that. Now, what are the various websites for e-reservation facility? MakeMyTrip.com, GoIBIBO.com, ClearTrip.com, Yatra.com, BookMyShow.com. Apart from these websites, if you know any other website and that is a legal website, you can write that also. But again, I'm focusing on the same point. While writing the website name, please write the complete URL. Don't just write the single name. Okay. Now, what are the benefits of e-reservation? The same benefits you have for e-shopping: safe, convenient, easy, fast. Okay. Available anytime, anywhere. You can be at any part of the country, anywhere you are, whatever the time may be. You can book the tickets. Okay. Then comes e-governance. I give one live example to you, and those of you who have availed this facility, only they will raise their thumb. Booking of Aadhaar card online or driving license online or PAN card online. Yes. Might be your father has booked driving license online and you witnessed that. Anyone? Please raise your thumb to give your feedback. Yes. I give one more example to you. Recently, you appear for Pariksha Pe Charcha. How many of you appear for Pariksha Pe Charcha? Arshin only. Only one child from entire 10th. Kritika, Khushi, Prabhgun, Aditya Sharma, Simarleen, Tanya, Gursevak, Parth of 10th A, Chand, Imani, Raina, Janvi, Aditi. Let me see how many are attending the lecture. Naina. Gia 19, roll number of 10th D, not attending the lecture. Rahul Verma, not in the class. Himanshu of 10th A, not in the class. Sayam is there. 19, roll number Gia, 10th D. Twice your name has been announced. Are you here in the class? She is not there. Himanshu of 10th A. Are you here in the lecture? Himanshu is not here in the class. So I should remove them if they are not in the. Yes, Gia, after 5 minutes, you are entering the class. Somebody might have told you that your name has been announced. Aryansh is not here. Prabhnoor is not here. Chayank is not here. Thumbs are not up. Jayaditya is not here. Okay. Madhav, 29 roll number, are you here in the lecture? Okay, it's okay, Madhav. Harsimran Kaur of 10th D. Bhanu Pratap, 10th D. Okay. After 5 minutes, I'm going to ask questions from you and I'll be taking name of any child. So be attentive in the lecture. So Pariksha Pe Charcha, when you entered your ID and password, that was the government website, mygov.in. That is e-governance. You book Aadhaar card online. You book driving license online. Parivahan.com. Okay. So what actually is e-governance? It refers to the application of electronic means in the government sector with the objective to fulfill all the needs, all the demands and requirements of citizens of country in an easy and a fast way. Actually, it is an interaction between government and citizens, between government and businessmen. Like you are the citizen of India, okay? And being the resident of Jalandhar city, you might be having some official work, some government link work, which you can fulfill, which you can get done by accessing the government website. Okay, like you are paying the electricity bill, PSPL, jo bhi website hai, that is a government website, right? So there is one plan which has been created by government, that is National E-Governance Plan, known as NEGP. Okay, what the main role of this plan is? To provide all the government services easily accessible to the common man, to every citizen, with greater efficiency, transparency, and reliability, with the purpose, with the objective that every service is provided at minimum cost and which is affordable to every citizen. ऐसा नहीं है कि ये सर्विस एक पर्सन को सूटेबल है, दूसरे को सूटेबल नहीं है. ऑल द गवर्नमेंट सर्विसेज शुड बी अवेलेबल फॉर ऑल द सिटीजंस एट मिनिमम कॉस्ट एंड विच शुड बेनिफिट द सिटीजंस ऑफ कंट्री. आधार कार्ड फैसिलिटी ऑनलाइन बुकिंग सबके लिए अवेलेबल है. पैन कार्ड बुकिंग सबके लिए अवेलेबल है. वोटर कार्ड फैसिलिटी सबके लिए अवेलेबल है. It's not restricted to some persons. Okay. Then these are the websites which are linked with the government work, e-governance, passport.gov.in, mca.gov.in. MCA means Ministry of Corporate Affairs. You can note it down somewhere. MCA means Ministry of Corporate Affairs. India.gov.in. DRDO.NIC.in, Supreme Court of India.NIC.in, RTI, okay, Right to Information, Parivahan.gov.in, where you book for your learning license or driving license, okay? So what are the benefits of e-governance? Clear efficiency, improved efficiency, right? And fast delivery of the service, reduce the wastage of time. No need to stand in the lines, okay? And you can easily access your service. Suppose you want to book the Aadhaar card. You can open the website, you can fill the formalities, and you click on the submit button. They will send you the message. You can download the receipt, and the process is very fast, right? No need to stand in heavy lines and waiting for your turn. So efficient process is provided to you. Fast process is provided to you. The only thing is you have to log in into that web particular website. Everything is transparent. Everything is clear. Each and every instruction is given to each and every citizen. Convenient for all. Right? Then the next point is increased public participation. It is open for everyone. The services given by the government are open to everyone. It is not any hard and fast rule that particular service is available to particular group of citizens. No, the services are available for every person, every citizen. Am I clear up till here? Now I'll be asking questions from you. So whosoever name I announced, the child will unmute himself or herself. My question to Bissam of 10th D. Are you here, bete? Okay, unmute yourself, Bissam. Am I audible to you, Bissam? Bissam, you're not audible. Am I audible to you? Yes, Bissam. I think some technical fault. Okay, Janvi, am I audible? Unmute yourself.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Janvi, question for you. Tell me any one website which is linked with the government work. I have just discussed.
Sir, mygovernment.in.
Yeah, mygov.in. Okay, the same website where you participate for Pariksha Pe Charcha. Right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
All right. Next question for Naina. Naina, please unmute.
Good afternoon, sir.
Very good afternoon, Naina. Naina, my question from you is, name any two websites which are linked with e-shopping. Any two, which you know?
Sir, www.amazon.com and www.mintra.com.
Okay, okay, fine. Unmute yourself. Mute yourself, sorry. Okay. Now coming back to the topic, drawbacks of e-governance. Still in rural areas, there are some persons or citizens who are unaware about technology. They cannot avail these government facilities which are available online. Okay, right? Because they are unaware about the technology. They are unaware about how to log in into the website, how to avail these services. They are not having good knowledge about technology. So that becomes a hindrance, an obstacle, a drawback for e-governance process. Okay, right? Then suppose you are availing some service and you have been asked to make payment online via debit or credit card. You will feel some doubt. You will hesitate that I am not going to make payment online. I may get risk that if I'm making the payment, I may not receive the service. I may not receive the Aadhaar card. I may not receive the PAN card. I may not receive my license. I may not receive my passport. My payment may be misused. My information may be misused. So all these doubts prevent you from availing these services. Right? Then comes e-groups. Beta, before I explain e-groups, I give one live example to you. Bring that live example here in the topic of e-groups and you will get to know the meaning of e-groups. Okay. Are you all here? Na? Chand, Harsimran, Saharsh. As your name announced, you are to raise your thumb to show your presence. Tanushka, Diksha Taneja. Your presence must be shown to me by raising your thumb. Prabgun Kaur, Chahat. Okay, fine. Karan Jyot, 10th hai, 25 roll number. Are you here? Karan Jyot. Yeah, yeah. Okay, okay, Karan Jyot. I get to know. Okay. Okay. You people make WhatsApp group. You are very much expert in making groups. You people make WhatsApp group. One person becomes admin and you add other members and you discuss topics. You share videos, you share photographs. Suppose you put any photograph in the group, other persons start giving comments on that. You shared some video, other persons of the group, they start giving comments on that video. They share their ideas, they share their views, and a sort of chat starts in the group, not with one person, with multiple persons. Am I right? Bring this example in e-groups. Voluntarily, willingly, some persons, they create an online community and they share topic of their interest. Maybe some friends have grouped together to form any online group and they share so many things in that group. They share photographs, they share videos, they discuss some topic, maybe some government topic, topic concerning COVID, anything. And other members, they give their response. They give their ideas, their views about the discussed topic. Right? So this is e-groups, electronic groups. And what are the examples? Websites in.groups.yahoo.com, groups.google.com. Okay, got it? Now, what are the advantages of e-groups? Convenient method, easy method. More persons can be involved. Group can be enlarged. Okay, cost effective. No cost is involved in this. Views of every person can be shared. Information can be shared with multiple persons. Right? Then comes your next topic, which you are already familiar with, social networking. Social networking means when you are on social media and you are interacting with your friends, with your relatives, with your colleagues, with your client, with your customers. Okay. And you share so many things with them. Right? Anything that connects you, anything that connects you with your relatives, with your friends, maybe within the country, maybe outside the country, that is social networking. And these are the social networking sites. Before this, let me clear your doubt. Whenever you get the question for social networking sites, do not write WhatsApp, do not write Snapchat. They are not social networking sites. Okay. Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, MySpace, Blogger, Flickr, Reddit, YouTube, WordPress, and TypePad. Now, what are the advantages of social networking? Easy to connect with people. Okay. All over the world, you can connect easily. You can have discussions. You can have their opinions. You can receive posts. You can like the post. You can share emoticons. Okay. Disadvantages. Misuse of information. Sometimes maybe any person who is having some problem with you, they may put wrong comments. They may try to ruin your image online. Cyberbullying. Kisi ki fake ID bana di, kisi ko humiliate karne ke liye. Okay. Cyber stalking, cyber bullying. All these problems, they are a major drawback in the social networking sites. Okay. Then attention seeking disorder. Students waste a lot of time on social networking. Okay, they are more interested in discussing topic about their interest rather than paying attention to the studies. 10th hai, sun rahe ho na? Then what are the features available on social networking sites? You can create your profile, you can create blogs, you can create your album, you can create groups, you can have discussion boards, you can have media gallery, complete gallery is available, video, photos, okay, walls, Facebook ki wall pe aap, you can put your status, messaging, Facebook Messenger, Yahoo Messenger, okay, Instagram, you can do chat also, right, comments, you can receive comments on your photograph, comments on the videos, tags, you can tag your friend on the photograph, okay, multiple friends you can tag. Then some technologies regarding your mobile, SMS, short message service, everybody knows, okay, textual message which you can send from one device to other device, right, and there is a limitation on the amount of characters that you can type in the as a length of your SMS message. These days the smartphone, they have increased the capacity of the message, but in earlier mobile phones the capacity was very less, limited amount of characters would have typed. Then is MMS, multimedia message service, a message which involves your multimedia elements, text, audio, video, graphics, okay, you can share photographs, you can share videos via MMS, clear, right? The capacity of MMS is more than the capacity of SMS. In SMS you cannot share your videos, in normal SMS, MMS means you can share multimedia elements, clear? Then you have 3G technology. 3G technology means third generation technology, right? These days, the present time, we are using 4G. 5G is under development. 5G is under development. Okay. We are using 4G. Earlier, we were using 3G. What 3G means? Third generation. What was the speed that was available in 3G? The speed was 2 Mbps, megabits per second. What is megabits per second? Beta, megabits per second means the unit to measure the amount of information that has been transferred. If B is capital, if B is capital, that will be bytes, megabytes. Okay. Increased bandwidth. What is bandwidth? Beta, ek channel. There is one channel. Okay. And it has a frequency level. Right. The difference between the highest and the lowest frequency, that is bandwidth. Okay. What other facilities were given in 3G? Multimedia services were provided. You were able to browse. You were able to do video conferencing. You were able to listen audio files. You were able to view the video files. Then keeping in mind all these things, more advanced features were given in 4G, fourth generation, more high speed network as compared to 3G, fast download and fast upload. There is one difference between upload and download. Upload means when you are transferring the file from your computer to the remote computer on the server. Downloading means when you are transferring file from server to your local computer. Okay, got it? So 4G was more fast, more reliable, provide more streaming of audio and video files, right? And high definition videos that you can watch under the fourth generation. Clear? I hope I'm clear with all the topics. Yes, 10th class.